We have Chiara String Quartet, Rebecca Fisher and Julie Yoon on violin, Jonas Sirota on viola, and I'm Greg Beaver on cello. And we play all kinds of music. Out of curiosity, has anyone heard that piece we just played before? People have. Okay. So that was a string quartet, from a string quartet by Joseph Haydn. And it's a few years older than the United States, I think. So the string quartet has been around for a while as an ensemble, and there are a lot of groups making their livings like us just playing this music, so it's a really exciting thing for us to do. And there are still people writing music for the quartet today, and we're going to play a piece that was written last year, right? Or 2 years ago. 2 years ago. It's called Milagros, which means miracles. And Gabriela Lena Frank, the composer, is an American composer. She lives in Berkeley, California. And she wrote us this 8-movement work on a commission. We asked her to write it and then paid her a lot of money to write this piece. And so we got this result. We're going to play just two of the movements for you. Just two of the movements for you. The two of the middle movements. Amantini, which is a depiction of an island, the Galapagos Islands, I believe, that she visited at night, and there were these incredible shadows from the moon. And so you'll hear in the beginning sort of like a Jonah is walking along and the shadow chases him. That kind of thing happens throughout this movement. Yes, we're the shadow. Gabriel wrote this piece after doing some extensive research visiting South America and the Andes Mountains in particular, and listening to the music, learning about the folk music, and incorporating it into her own style. We're going to play another movement from the same piece called Adios a Chudin, which is a farewell to a steep mountain village called Chudin, which is almost a ghost town. All of the youth are moving to the big cities in Peru. And so it's an incredibly beautiful movement, and I like playing it because I get to play the melody. So, Amantini and Adios a Chudin from Milagros.
Thank you.
Quartet was opus 76, number 5, and we played the
not going to play the second movement, which is kind of sad. But third movement, then.
Thank you. Thank you. point, we recorded the Brahms quartet this past season, and we were trying to decide how can we kind of make this the experience more special for us, and how can we make it more, you know, sometimes it can be a very intense thing getting in a recording studio and spending, you know, hours and hours doing take after take, and we wanted to find a way to make it fresh and a new experience for us. And so we decided that we would, for the first time, we would memorize a piece, well, three pieces actually, and spent, yeah, almost four. We didn't end up doing the fourth, but we had a collaborator who was a little spooky the last minute, okay. So this idea originated, I think, for us from the Polish quartet, a famous quartet from earlier in last century, who played everything from memory. Or as they said, played by heart. And I think it's a great way to think about it. We found that not having the music in front of us has really allowed us to focus on each other, on each other's parts, on the sort of motion and synergy of what we're doing much more readily, and we really enjoy it. We will do it with as much as we possibly can. The process of learning it is you've got to stuff a lot of notes in there. So, anyway, let's unstuck some for you, shall we? This is the full four-movement string quartet of a 67 B-flat by Johannes Brahms, the last quartet that he wrote. And Brahms was a deep guy with a lot of deep, intense thoughts, but this quartet was written while he was on vacation, and is as close to light and chauffeur as he gets. Not all in chauffeur, but it's pretty cool.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.